bring Barrett Brooks into the conversation for Barrett's Breakdown here on the Sports Bash 97.3 ESPN. And BB, let's jump into a couple of things real fast here, because obviously Monday night, big game here, because if Philly wins this game, they would have beaten Washington twice and, you know, put themselves at 6-1, a big separation there. So do you find that tonight's game is a bigger game for Philly at 5-1 or Washington at 3-2?
It's probably a bigger game for Philly, you know, and not just because I'm an Eagles fan, but I think more so because it just shows that, you know, Philadelphia is above and beyond what anybody else in the division is. You know, you look at this team, and they should be with the point that they're at because they're built, you know, strategically, you know, from the offensive line to the defensive line. So, yes, I really think that they should go out there and win this game, and it should just, you know, be that X factor that gives this team the sense that, all right, we are the guys on top of the hill. We must establish ourselves as that. And you really don't want Washington to sneak in there.
Yeah, I kind of agreed. You know, earlier you felt like, all right, if Washington can win this game, that gets them, you know, but Philly has had so much national publicity. If they lose a game at home like this, all of a sudden the naysayers and the doubters start to creep back in. This is really a big reputation game tonight and a separation kind of game. And then if they lose, the next thing you hear is, all right, Philly loses at home and Dallas won by 30. Is Dallas the team that's going to catch Philly? So this is a big game for the Eagles in terms of, I think, the mental aspect of proving to people that they are what their record says they are.
Yeah, this establishment, just like you said, this is a separation type of game. This is like, all right, we are who we say we are or what we think we are, but it also solidifies what everybody else is also saying about us and thinking.
How about Zach Ertz tonight? I mean, the first game he had 8 catches for 93 yards in 9 games against Washington, Barrett. He has had 54 catches for 531 yards. It's the best against any team. They're banged up in the secondary, which means, you know, somebody in this Eagles secondary should have a big game tonight. Who's the guy for you that you keep an eye on for Philly?
Well, you know, I'm still going to stick with Ertz. Ertz had to have a good game against this team. He has solidified himself as one of the best tight ends in the league. And I think, you know, just because the Nitro Hopkins are starting to try to take him out of the game, he's now looked at as like a Gronkowski or even a Kelsey, because he has become Carson's number one target. He wants to get the ball to him, especially when he's in trouble. And Ertz understands that, and he's you know, taking his game to another level and being that safety blanket for him. He's running routes better, and the biggest thing is he understands where Carson is looking for him, and them two have a camaraderie between themselves that he can't go to him. The fact the teams are now starting to bracket him a lot, and that they bring in a safety in the box to try to double team him or bring a linebacker underneath with help from the safety just shows the respect that he has as far as trying to defend him. But he's also finding a way to get open from those guys also. They call it a plaster drill. Whenever Carson gets out of the pocket, they try to plaster the receivers. Ertz understands how to get out of those plaster situations and become that target that Carson's looking for.
BB, you made your living on the offensive line, so what about up front where you specialize? What do you think of the Eagles' O-line right now and protecting Wentz especially? He's been hit 43 times this season. That's the second most in the NFL.
Well, you know, this team is going to have to – the Washington Redskins are going to have to blitz them. They're going to have to blitz them because they don't have the guys up front with Allen being out. And Kerrigan, you know, I think we finally figured out how to block Kerrigan. We got to keep a tight end inside, bring a chipper his way to slow him down. So because of that, we know how to block him. So they're going to have to blitz him. But the thing is, when you blitz Carson, if he gets out and gets any moment of being free, he can deliver ball down the field, and they don't have the DBs right now. They don't have those healthy DBs to help them out in that situation. So this is going to be a big game for the other guys to see if they can step it up, especially going to Nelson Aguilar, because he's come that big play threat that the Eagles have been looking for a long time. He's finally come out of his shell, and now he's looked to as being a guy that can go out there and kind of take a lot of the stress off. You know, we used to look to Sproles as being that weapon, that explosive type of player. Well, now Nelson Aguilar has become that explosive player. He's now the best probably weapon that Carson has at his disposal to make a big play.
So with all the injuries in the Washington secondary you mentioned, and Mike and I talked about, and we talked about the hits that Carson Wentz is taking, does it make more sense to take the shots down the field, or does it make more sense to maybe turn to the running game a little bit? Blunt had just 14 for 46 in week one.
Well, we have to run the ball. You know, we cannot deviate from what we've done the past 3 or 4 weeks. We have to run the ball, establish a run, which opens up everything else. With that play action, with the notion that he can run the ball at any time, put Carson in a better position to go down the field. And you can go down the field with that, because a lot of the time people don't run run fakes for necessarily the fact that they're trying to run, but they use it as bringing in an extra back blocker, an extra guy to help with protection, you know, as almost a maximum protection. They just use a run fake on it also. It just leaves a lot more blockers in there to block and gives you a lot more time to have those long developing routes down the field. And that's what they use it for the most part for. I don't think the Eagles necessarily want to pick anybody out as far as running a run fake. They just use it as a max protection to get the ball down the field, because it gives them more opportunity, because you have those extra blockers staying in and helping Carson out of protection.
Barrett's breakdown here on 97.3 ESPN. Barrett, a lot of talk this week about Chris Thompson and the Washington screen game. Does he concern you, or is there another area of their offense that concerns you?
No, you know, you have to look at him. Chris Thompson has become that threat that, you know, if you look at him, it's not necessarily what he does in the run game. It's what he does in the pass game, which is an extension of the run game. A lot of screens, trying to take advantage of how aggressive the D-line of the Eagles are. They're going to try to leak him out a little bit. And I tell you what, one-on-one with a linebacker, I mean, it's going to be tough. You know, it's going to be tough. It's almost like Sproles when he's one-on-one a guy. That's almost like a layup for Sproles. Well, Chris Thompson's become that type of back. It's a layup if you get him one-on-one against the linebacker. So they're going to have to use, you know, a lot of people that are trying to stop this guy. They may have to, you know, go with just Hicks, you know, mainly on him and spying him. They have to do something to try to alleviate his big play ability also, because if they don't, he could, you know, virtually kill him, especially on third downs or you know, even going in and in the red zone. He's that good of a player. But, you know, Malcolm Jenkins being in the box, and he'll have an opportunity to go against them. I don't think they necessarily respect receivers of the Washington Redskins as much as they have done in the past. They're not, you know, as adept as they used to be when they had, you know, guys like I forgot his name.
Garcon and Jackson, obviously.
No,
yeah,
Jackson.
Hey,
yeah,
right. Hey, Barrett, one thing, you know, the first time they played, you talk about the big play and the receivers. I recall those receivers getting behind the Eagles secondary. Cousins just not on that day, had a drop by Terrell Pryor. You know, that's something that concerns you a little bit, is that they were getting behind the Eagles secondary in week one. They just weren't executing.
Well, that's what I'm saying. That's why I said that I don't think that they necessarily respect them. And I really think it's because the guys up front have really taken upon themselves to say, all right, we're going to impact the passing game more so than the DBs in the back end. We understand that, you know, Dotson's a good player. He's a good slot player. He's become that go-to guy. So you have to put pressure on Cousins. Cousins doesn't like to get hit. And if you start hitting him, he starts seeing ghosts. It's not all the time if you sack a guy. Like, it's just a little thing. You know, if BG turns around, Brandon Graham goes around, and he's almost there, just tap him on the shoulder. Hey, I was almost there. Now he starts seeing ghosts. Now he starts, you know, speeding up his progression. Now he starts not using the proper footwork.
Right.
And that's when things don't, you know, come as far as execution on how to run that offense. So if they put pressure on him early, get him a little flush a little bit, take him out of his game, it could be a long game for that offensive line and Cousins. And then, you know, they're less effective in going down the field like they want to.
Barrett's breakdown here on the Sports Bash. Barrett, the NBC Sports Philadelphia crew, when will your guys' coverage begin tonight of this one?
Well, we will start at 7 o'clock. We'll have post-game, but I'll be on Quick Slash from 6 to 6:30. We're actually doing it from Xfinity Live, so come down and check us out when you get through. As you're on your way down, listen to you guys on the way.
Absolutely. As Barrett's breakdown here on the Sports Bash, you'll hear him on NBC Sports Philadelphia in Quick Slant and then post game live with the guys right there on NBC Sports Philadelphia. Before we let you run here, Barrett, 5-1, 3-2, Monday Night Football. Akers is going in tonight. We know a lot of times when there's a lot of juice in that building, you get the letdown game. Is tonight one of those nights?
No. Like I said, I think this is a special season. It's not because necessarily that, the Eagles is just being the Eagles. I think it's more so because they are solid in what they're trying to do. They understand that they could have a letdown. So because of that, I think the older veteran players will make sure they don't get caught up in the lights and everything, you know. So I like what, I mean, what is the Alabama coach said? You guys, you know, he said, too many reporters tell them how good they were. That's when you get snake bit. I don't think the veteran players will allow them to get snake bit and start believing in all the accolades and what they're saying about them. I think these guys will go out, go to work, and understand if they, in order for them to be successful, they got to do what they've been doing, and that's working.
All right, check out Barrett on Quick Slants and Post Game Live on NBC Sports Philadelphia. And for Barrett's breakdown every Monday here on the Sports Pass. Thank you, BB. We'll talk to you soon, pal.
Pete, Mike, I appreciate it, guys.